Python is an easy-to-use programming language due to its simple structure and focus on readability and reusability. This allows you to quickly prototype and test programs on multiple platforms. Using Python, you can develop your own Maya plugins, which expand Maya's capabilities. Maya plugins differ from scripts in that they can be used to create new commands, shaders, deformers, and so on. In this movie, we will cover the basics of how to load and run a simple command plugin into Maya. In doing so, we will examine the code's flow and identify the elements that are crucial to creating new plugins. Let's start off by creating a Hello World command, which we can use in either a MEL or a Python script. Here's a preview of what the execution of our command will look like in Maya's script editor. Open the Hello World command.py file in any text editor. We've chosen to open it in Eclipse, an open-source integrated development environment, to take advantage of syntax checking and highlighting. Note that Eclipse requires the PyDev plugin to open and edit Python files. First and foremost, all Maya plugins require two functions, initialize plugin and uninitialize plugin. When Maya attempts to load a Python plugin, it first searches for these two functions within the file. If either of these functions do not exist, Maya will fail to load the plugin. Both these functions require a single argument, which we name mObject. This argument is an instance of the mObject class, which Maya uses to wrap most of its internal classes. Instances of mObject are manipulated by compatible function sets. You can easily recognize function sets as classes prefixed by mfn. Here, this mObject instance represents an underlying plugin object. Next, to manipulate it, we construct an mfn plugin function set around it. We register our command into Maya by calling mplugin.registerCommand with the two following arguments. The first argument is the command name, which we've declared as a global variable at the top of the file. It determines the name of our new MEL command, as well as the name of our new Python function inside the maya.cmds module. The second argument is cmdCreator, which is a reference to the function responsible for creating instances of our command. cmdCreator uses the openmaya.mpx.asmpxptr function to pass an instance of our Python command as a C++ pointer into Maya. This calls the myCommand class constructor, which itself calls the Python class's init function. Note that because we're creating a command, our custom class must inherit from openmaya.mpx.mpxcommand. As such, our custom class's init function must call init on the mpxcommand base class. Similar in structure to initialize plugin, the uninitialize plugin function calls deregisterCommand using only the command name as an argument. You might have noticed by now that we are making extensive use of the maya.openmaya.mpx module, renamed to openmaya.mpx using the as keyword. We need to import this module because it is necessary to create any Maya plugin. The majority of the classes in this module are prefixed by mpx, which are known as proxy classes. By inheriting from any one of these classes, your own classes can adopt specific roles within Maya. These roles include commands, deformers, shaders, and generic node types, to name just a few. Just remember to call init on the appropriate base class. In addition to the openmaya.mpx module, you can import a variety of other Maya modules. The maya.openmaya module contains general purpose classes and functions you will use to manipulate various scene elements such as meshes, lights, cameras, and many more. The OpenMaya Anim module contains animation classes including those used to manipulate animation curves, characters, and keyframes. The OpenMaya FX module contains effect classes for hair, particle, and fluid systems. The OpenMaya Render module contains classes used to manipulate geometry, shaders, textures, and rendering. The OpenMaya UI module contains classes which allow you to manipulate the Maya user interface. Lastly, the OpenMaya Cloth module contains classes to manipulate cloth effects. Getting back to our code, we use the Python built-in sys module for error reporting. The doit function contains the working code for when we actually execute the command. For now, the command isn't doing anything, as indicated by the Python pass keyword. Let's add a simple print statement to output a hello world in the script editor, as proof of our command's execution. Now that we've defined its behavior, let's look at how to load and execute our command plugin. To do this, place the hello world command.py file into your Maya version's plugins directory. When Maya starts up, it scans this directory and lists its contents in the plugin manager. Optionally, if you already have a plugin directory set up somewhere else, such as on a shared drive, you can place this file in a directory referenced by the Maya plugin path environment variable, which Maya also checks on startup. Setting this environment variable is operating system specific and is outside the scope of this movie. Open Maya and navigate to Window, Settings Preferences, Plugin Manager. In the Plugin Manager, locate the HelloWorldCommand.py plugin based on its directory path. Check Loaded to load this plugin into Maya. Toggling this checkbox will unload and reload your plugin into Maya. This is useful to test various iterations of your plugin's code. Note that Loaded loads the plugin for the current Maya session only, while Autoload ensures that Maya loads it automatically on startup. The HelloWorldCommand.py file defines a new Hello command. As we mentioned earlier, this command is not only added to Mel, but is also added as a new function to the Maya.cmds Python module. To run this command, open the script editor and select the Python tab. First, type import maya.cmds as cmds. This will provide our script with access to the maya.cmds module. Then, on a second line, type cmds.hello. Now highlight both lines and click the execute button. You'll notice that the two lines are echoed in the script editor's top pane, as well as the command's output, Hello World. You should now have a better understanding of how to load and execute any Python plugin into your Maya environment. To learn more about Python plugin development, explore the Python plugin learning path in the Maya API guide.